appreciate the attendance of everyone. We will go to the agenda. Anybody? Mr. Frost, you have any agenda changes?
No, sir. Mr. Chair, I have.
Mr. Lyon?
No, Mr. Chair. No, sir.
Any commissioners? Any motion to...
Motion to accept the agenda changes.
Second.
There's a motion by Commissioner John Ray Thomas, second by Commissioner Terry Langford to approve the agenda. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. You've had an opportunity with the consent agenda.
Motion to approve.
Approve.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Kenny Thomas, the second by Commissioner Todd Gray to approve the consent agenda. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Okay, we go to public participation. This time. Any public have any issues they want to bring before the board?
Yes, I'd like to.
Come up and state your name, please, for the record.
Ben Studstill. Live on 339 County Line. I like to have that road closed down. That's in behind my house. That's 105th Street. We've been there about 15 years, and this is the fourth robbery we've had in our house. They backed right up to our house, pretty much cleaned us out. We had two breakers in less than 12 days.
All right. How many people live on that road?
Two people.
Two people?
I'm not...
Does the other person agree to close it?
Yes, sir.
Have you informed Billy about this, the road superintendent? Does he know about this?
Yes, me and Mr. Gannon wrote it, and I've been in contact with Mr. Studstill with this on two or three occasions on the telephone. And the road he's referring to is the County Line Road that runs on the southbound. And it runs directly behind his house, probably from here to that wall there to hit that door.
Is it heavily used traffic?
Is this the one you called me about, Billy?
It is. One of the ties in 129 all the way to 339. By the old Bob Batcher's house. Once you get down to Ms. Watson's and Ms. Priestson's Jones intersection, there on that.
It comes out there by the old Bob Batcher's house? Which one passes along that street?
Right, the stretch he's talking about, there were the two houses right there from Priestson Jones Road back to 339, where Ms. Watson lives and he lives. But it is County Line Road that ties in from 129. But there's also an access road, it's Santa Fe Road that comes back out to 339.
That's Priestson Jones Road.
And it's a double, and there's plenty of passing lane on that road.
Do you have any issues with us discussing, considering this public, Mr. Kenny?
No, I hadn't even talked to Mr. Lyon yet about it. Me and Mr. Crosby talked about it. That's all we've done is talk, because we haven't had any formal requests as far as being in writing.
And I think we don't have a procedure we can follow for this, where you fill out an application.
Well, have you filed an application to have a...
That's why I'm here.
Well, if you'll get with our attorney or administrator, Mr. Kenny, there's a procedure to do this, and we will certainly give it consideration after that application is made. So this is your starting point. You need to do that so we can look at it and review it and make sure that anybody that lives on that road, our policy has been that if you want to close it, they don't close it. So we'd like to help if we can, but go through that process and let's see where we get, where we go.
Mr. Chair, can I say a couple words?
Yep.
I talked to Commissioner Kenny Thomas and talked with Ken briefly about it. Mr. and Ms. Stussy actually wrote me a letter, and I called Ms. Stussy about it and told her what the process was. And this was essentially kind of a meet and greet today to see if there was just, you know, apparent disinterest in doing this. They're aware of the process they have to follow to get this done. And I refer them to the website, and they know the procedures because you actually need the process. have a step-by-step procedure that they have to follow here done. But it does start with a petition close to road, notify all the property owner, and then have a time certain up here in front of the board. But they didn't want to go do all that if just was apparent that it was not going to go forward.
The question's been arise too. Is he going to have to get a legal survey of that road?
I think he will because of the fact that we're not sure if part of that road is in Levy County or not. So we need some kind of evidence that it's all in Gilchrist County. Because if you close the road and have it over in Levy County, then they've only accomplished half the job. They've got to do the board meeting too to get permission from them.
Billy thought that we figured that any road that we grade or maintain at our level of maintenance.
Prescriptive easement, because I think they're allowing you to do some work that they don't have to do. Legally speaking, if the road's in their county, they're going to have to give permission as well, even though we utilize it by prescriptive maintenance.
So if you'll follow that process, we'll see where we go with it.
All right, appreciate it.
Thank you.